It is Animal Kingdom Day. We just arrived at the park. It is 6:40 a.m. and it is so humid out that my camera keeps getting foggy. So hopefully this doesn't happen all day, but let's go ride some rides. We are through security, walking up to the gate. This is gonna be a great day. Animal Kingdom is my favorite park.
Always use the same finger. But yeah, sometimes it's hard for it to turn green with the little finger. Awesome, thank you. Perfect. Use the same.
Flying on the back of this powerful animal called an Ikran, or as we call it, a Banshee. The way you're gonna do this is by being matched to something called an avatar.
Dora Conservation Initiative, you're about to experience a ceremony that's very special to the Na'vi.
Deberán permanecer sentados.
Just got off Flights of Passage. Always a really fun ride. It's one of people's favorite here at Animal Kingdom. I personally think though that I'm ready for them to have like a new video for it. Same video kind of gets old sometimes. Still very fun, don't get me wrong. Very good scent on that ride as well. But I'd love if they did something with the new Avatar Way of Water and kind of incorporated that, because I think that'd be really cool to see. Now we're gonna go on Na'vi River Journey before the line gets really long. It's only about 10 minutes right now. Oh wow, this is really fogging up. So we're gonna go hop on that ride before it gets long. Let's change of plans. We're actually gonna go and head over for our lightning lane over at Kilimanjaro Safari. My favorite ride in all of Disney World, but I'm a little biased because I just really like animals. So we're gonna go over to Africa and go ride that.
It's like we're back in Namibia.
We don't want anyone to stand up inside the truck. Now take a look above you. Now the black rhino is one of two rhino species that live on the reserve, so we might see some more rhinos a bit later on when we reach the savannah. On the hill, you might catch a glimpse of a dark orange animal with white stripes and horns. That is a bongo. Now both the bongo and the greater kudu utilize those white stripes as part of their camouflage. They'll hide in the brush and the sunlight comes through the leaves and blends in perfectly with those stripes. Baobab tree gets the nickname the Tree of Life because it can hold thousands of gallons of water in its trunk. Not a lot of animal activity this morning. Now that a size giraffe, 18 to 20 feet tall, that is the longest neck in the animal kingdom. Surprisingly, a giraffe's neck is only made up of families that always identify each other, and of course, mothers can always identify their young. Now, the official name for a group of zebras is a dazzle. That's because when they all stand together, a predator can't tell one zebra apart from another because the stripes help dazzle the predator. Now, on the island, these are greater flamingos. They're the largest crustaceans. It takes about a year to a year and a half for a flamingo to truly develop that pink color. They're a bit bigger than the black rhino we saw back in the forest. Vite is an Afrikaans word, means wide, and the name referred to the animal's wide mouth. For a few seconds, definitely sprinter versus a marathoner. Unlike other African cats, lions will sleep 18 hours a day because they need to conserve their energy for when they hunt. And when it comes to lions, females are the hunters. Males are going to stay behind to look after the cubs.
When I'm grabbing from the branch and going back.
Corey was actually born here at Animal Kingdom with his brother, who was also in here, and they both moved over to this side from the family troop side to learn how to be good silverbacks in the future. So that way, hopefully, they will be able to leap and have families of their own someday.
So some people don't know that the best spot to take the photo in front of the Tree of Life is actually between Africa and Asia, not out that first bridge that you cross when you walk into the park.
All right, it is now time to go ride Expedition Everest. We have a lightning lane, so we don't have to wait at all. We're gonna hop right on this line, and it's gonna be so much fun.
are now going to ride again and go through the single rider entrance. About to get on for the second time. There was absolutely no wait in that single rider line. We got on immediately. We are now walking from Expedition Everest back to Kilimanjaro Safari to ride for a second time. We now have a lightning lane. I highly recommend always riding Kilimanjaro Safari three times in a day. First thing in the morning, right after Flight of Passage, around lunchtime, and then after 5 p.m. If you go after 5 p.m., you'll be able to see the hyenas that they keep in the African wild dog habitat, because they actually swap them out around 4 o'clock. So that's a great time if you actually want to go see hyenas. It's a little fact that no one really knows about, is that they do have hyenas here at Animal Kingdom.
Caribou is a small hyena where they mean small.
Beautiful stripes on their back legs that make them look a lot like a zebra, but they're actually the only close relative to the giraffe. Over here on the left-hand side, kind of up on top of the hill, there's two saddle-billed storks, and both of them are sitting down right now. But when they stand at their full height, they can reach 5 feet tall, with an average wingspan of 9. Darker brown in both males and females have horns.
See ya, Bubba.
They both have white stripes to camo. Both males and females have these horns. The males do tend to be a little bit darker brown and slightly larger. And they do angle their horns back to keep them from getting tangled in all the thick brush that they hide in. The bushes and trees provide these animals with cover, but on the left-hand side, there's some hippos hanging out behind the island. Hippos spend the majority of their day in the water. Make sure we're all staying seated for me, please, including those little ones that need to be sitting down. Hippos can hold their breath for up to 8 minutes at a time. They can slide here on the left. Good at working together. There's some Ankole cattle over here on our left as well. The Ankole cattle's horns can get to be 6 feet long. They might look heavy, but they're actually hollow on the inside. One of the oldest domesticated species in the world. Browsers out on the savannah, they're the tallest animals in the world and the only ones who can reach most of the trees. So they'll take advantage of having no competition for that food source. Giraffes spend almost their entire day eating. They usually eat for about 20 hours a day, and they only sleep for like the wildebeest gathered over here on our right. Not a lot of wildebeest out here on the reserve, but their herds in the wild can number up to 1.5 million. And they stay in their groups as they migrate about 1,000 miles. The largest species of antelope in the world, the springbok, are one of the smallest.
Did you see the elephant?
We are, of course, going to be seeing African elephants out here on the African savanna. There are a few visual differences between them and their Asian cousins. Tell your lives. Seen a few elephants around here, we might be coming up on one of these family groups. It starts out pink. They all come out of their shells looking a bit like little gray fluff balls. There are some babies. Rhinos we'll find out on the savannah are white rhinos, the largest of them all. Adults usually weigh around 5,000 pounds. They like to hang around this mud wallow because rhinos roll around ambush predators. That's how they hunt. And unlike most cats who are nocturnal, cheetahs are diurnal. They're most active during the day. That's so no one bigger or stronger than them will be around napping on the rocks here. It is sleepy time for lions, and it will continue to be sleepy time for quite a while. Lions sleep for about 18 to 20 hours a day. During the day, their eyesight's about the same as ours, and at night, it's 6 times better, so they spend their days conserving their energy for hunting at night. Not that males do any of the hunting, that's the female's job. You can see pretty girl napping right above the handsome man here. Females outnumber males in any given pride, so the girls have the strength and numbers that they need to hunt successfully. So the girls are the ones going out to hunt while the males hang back to protect the pride. Even when they split up, they can still communicate. And they're just the cutest little guys! But they're also very useful animals to have around on pastures. The goats have amazing digestive systems. They'll eat pretty much anything. So they clear out the tougher vegetation that other cattle can't or won't eat. Kind of like a more sustainable, but also adorable.
As I've said before, Kilimanjaro Safari is my favorite ride in all of Disney. I highly recommend sitting all the way to the left in the back row if you ever ride. I think it's the best view. Most of the good things are all the way to the left, so it's kind of hard to see if you're on the right side. So sit in the back because you'll have more time to look at the things, and all the way to the left because you'll be closest to all the cool things. But now we are going to go over to Rafiki's Planet Watch over at Conservation Station. So okay, we're going to take a little train on over there.
You'll discover a wide range of animals in the affection section. Personal with domesticated animals like goats, sheep, and more, to Walt Disney himself and his long-standing passion for conservation. He believed it was important that we protect our wildlife and preserve our natural world. This sense of motivation shaped his legacy from animation to conservation, the Jungle Book, and more.
We are at Conservation Station. Welcomed immediately by Rafiki.
Look, we got Timon out here
doing a meet and greet. We got a Komodo dragon right here. That's really cool how Animal Kingdom and Disney as a whole allows people to see so much. So we were able to just watch a literal porcupine procedure, and any animal that comes in for a procedure you can literally watch. So I think that's super cool. And then they also have 2 seasons of that show, Magic of Disney's Animal Kingdom. You get to go behind the scenes on that show and just watch all the stuff that they're doing, medically, husbandry training, all that. So I think that's just really cool how Disney is so transparent about their care with the public, because it paints a really great image for the professional animal care field as a whole. We are back at the train, about to hop on. Get back in time for our lunch reservation at Yak.
We are now approaching
We are inside Yak and Yeti, one of my favorite restaurants here in Animal Kingdom.
Here, your table and cherry. Thank you.
So I ordered the strawberry margarita. Comes with this shaker. And there's essentially two margaritas worth in that shaker. So you're only paying $16 for two margaritas. And you get to keep the shaker as well. Got some wonton soup. So I got a side of coconut shrimp, as well as some honey chicken with chicken fried rice. That was an awesome lunch. Yak and Yeti is always just has fantastic food. The honey chicken is always so, so good. Oh, we actually have a sighting of Kevin right now. We've got Kevin right on over here. We are at the Festival of the Lion King. Gonna get in line because we have a Lightning Lane pass.
Looks like a vacuum made from the same company.
Greetings, everyone. Mabari, welcome. We have been expecting you. We are here today to welcome you, one and all, to the Festival of the Lion King.
Hello, we are the humble and now welcome to our world. Hello, to belong, we have love.
Here, put your fingers by your face to be your tusks. Yes, and now, make a snorty warthog sound.
Everyone, listen.
Hello! Hello!
Hello!
Look at me! I'm in a
everybody!
Hey, Pumba, Timon!
Look, everyone, it's the Lion King! Welcome, Simba! You're right on time!
Hey, guys! It looks like we're all here!
Stuff back, we'll get on with it. Hey, Maestro, what's with the music?
Something tells me this ain't the floor show.
Ah! Hey, what the? Hey there, big fella. Hey, nice hat. So, where you from?
I know video powers and retention. Our sweat as a warthog's backside. But think as you are, pay attention. My words are a matter of pride. Existing balance.
It is then that we are all connected in the great circle, the circle of life.
From the day that I opened my ears and began stepping to the sun, there's more to see than can ever be seen, more to do than can ever be done.
Festival of the Lion King is by far the best performance on Walt Disney World property in all the parks. I can't remember if I misspoke yesterday and said Beauty and the Beast was the best, but if I did, I misspoke, and this is the best. The energy in the theater is absolutely incredible. The performers are absolutely incredible. Everything is just done so, so well. The costumes, the aura, everything. It's literally perfect. Also, The Lion King is my favorite movie of all time, so I always just love it so, so much. But now we have Lightning Lane in Navi River Journey and then Flight of Passage. So we're gonna walk over to do that right now. It is starting to rain a little bit, so hopefully we can get inside quickly. I am so happy that Navi River Journey exists for the sole purpose of it's a long wait, so it takes a lot of people out of all the other lines and puts them in that line for a ride that's really not even that great in my opinion, but it is what it is. It'll fill some time. But now we are back here about to go ride Flights of Passage for the second time today.
By blending human DNA and Navi DNA. Once we match you to an avatar, thanks to a special link chair, your mind will be able to control that avatar and move around a bit. Almost. Yes, got him. Now, let's find you your avatar matches.
All the way down the number is Dangle and Janag matching room. 1-3 will be in the front, 9-16 will be in the back.
For your safety, throughout this entire experience, remain seated, lean forward, holding onto the hand grips, and supervise your children.
As always, it's a fun ride on Flight of Passage. I feel like they're spraying out more water than they usually do on that ride, but I don't know, that might just be me because I haven't been here for a while. But now we are headed over to Dinosaur. Absolutely love that ride. One of my favorite rides, and I'm so sad that they're getting rid of it. I wish they would just get rid of Dino Land but keep Dinosaur, but I don't make decisions around here, so that's not up to me. But now we're gonna go ride that, because maybe this will be the last time that we ever do ride it. Nope, that's a lie. Next week we'll be here to ride it again. But we're still gonna go ride it because it's a really great ride. We have a little pit stop at Nomad Lounge. It's a little hidden gem here at Animal Kingdom. It's gonna be right next door to Tiffin's. It's a nice little lounge over here that's got a view of the water and plenty of drinks. Very nice, comfortable lounge theme in here.
A little concentrate,
so it kind of gives it a little extra body out of it. And then to brighten it up, do a squeeze of lemon, and if that's not enough, it's on the side of the can. But the story's still there.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
So this is what Nomad Lounge looks like. It's all like this. So it's a really nice area. All right, we are finally in Dinosaur. I'm very surprised that I got in. I was 16 minutes late for my Lightning Lane time, and it's still lit up green. So now we're gonna go ride this awesome ride.
About to become extinct. In a perfect blending of science and technology, the Dino Institute has created the Time Rover. And a
Iguanodon and get out before that asteroid hits. Let's roll!
We are now in a hurry to go over and get to Kilimanjaro Safari. We've got 13 minutes, I think, until the ride is supposed to close and no one else can get in line. It also is only a 5-minute wait, which is kind of crazy for that ride. So I'm really hurrying up, trying to get over there before the ride closes because I want to ride one more time to go see some hyenas.
Hi, Pluto.
Hi, Pluto.
Hi.
I love you, Pluto. Couldn't help but make a quick pit stop looking at the river otters that they have here at Animal Kingdom. They're all just cuddling up, being super cute as always. Look at that view. Stunning shot right there. Look at this. It is just before 6 o'clock and the Africa area here at Disney's Animal Kingdom is empty. Normally, this whole area is just packed with people, but this place is literally empty, which explains only the 5-minute wait for Kilimanjaro Safari. Let's go see some hyenas. We are here just in time. Still says only a 5-minute wait. It is 5:54. We made it with 6 minutes to spare. There is literally no one else here in line. This is just me. This place is empty. Let's see, do they still have the cranes out? No, it looks like the cranes did go away for the night. That is totally okay. We're now gonna go through the safari booking office. One of the little areas that they have for people to look at as they're waiting in what is usually a very long line, but not right now. See, they've already taken up this barrier and you're just gonna walk right through. It is all just empty here.
It could be anywhere.
This is crazy. I was actually wrong. The cranes are all the way back in the corner. They're probably hiding because it was just absolutely pouring here. Yeah, they're just hanging out foraging for some food.
Unless because the doors are going to slide closed for you.
We are the last safari of the night.
Our first stop is the Aturi Forest. Now, typically animals out here in the forest like to use those camouflage skills to try to hide away from us, but we can already see that okapi over there on the far right. Now, it does often get mistaken for being related to the zebra because of those stripes. Now, the bongos get the nickname the ghost of the forest because it is pretty rare for you to see them out there. They are one of the ones that tend to be a little more shy. Believe it or not, that is going to be the smallest of the two types of rhinos that we have out here on the reserve. Weighing up to about 3,000 pounds, that rhino can run speeds up to about 35 miles per hour. More specifically, the females, because they do not have any horns. Or a group of hippos. Otherwise known as the Watusi cattle, based off the Watusi tribe in Africa. Now the horns on the cattle can... Now up here on the left looks like they are finally active, but you are going to see some of the African painted dogs. Now they get their name from those unique splotchy patterns that they have all across their bodies, which is how they can tell each other apart. Now they do look very cute and gentle now, but just know that they are the most successful hunters out in Africa. We have a wildebeest over here on the right. Now, wildebeest do like to remain in groups. We can see some of those Hartman's mountain zebras over there on the right. We'll see if we can get some better views of them up around this corner. Now, zebras are, of course, known for having those famous black and white...
Giraffe vibes.
Also can see those Maasai giraffes over here on the left.
There's one right there on the left.
Now when giraffes are born, they are already born about 6 feet tall. They can start standing and even walking and running about 30 minutes after birth.
I noticed everyone was looking to the right.
I was
like,
they're
right there.
They also spend about 18 hours of their day eating.
Look at that giraffe.
I hope someone's getting
a Looks like we can already see that male. Now lions do spend about 20 hours of their day doing just this, resting. When they eventually decide to wake up, the females will be responsible for going out and doing the hunting, while the males are going to stay behind to protect any of those cubs or any older lions that might be in the pack. Also over there on the right, we are passing by a water buck. It's going to be that animal with the white circles along their backside. Now the water bugs, they do secrete this very smelly, greasy liquid all over their bodies, which is going to make their coats pretty water resistant, and it also prevents them from really having any predators.
Alright, so I was the last ride of the night. Unfortunately, didn't see hyenas, so I asked a cast member afterwards, and I guess just recently the hyenas actually left Animal Kingdom and went off to another facility here in the United States. So you can no longer see hyenas after 4 p.m. here at the Kilimanjaro Safari. But I did get to see the brand new baby elephant that is just on Savannah just a few months ago for the first time. It was very far out and I didn't have time to get any footage of it or anything, but I still saw it, so that was really awesome. And maybe when I'm here next week, we'll have another opportunity to go see the baby elephant. All right, well, that does wrap up my day here at Disney's Animal Kingdom. My day's not over yet, so we are not going anywhere. So we still got a little bit of a trip to go. We are having dinner tonight at 1900 Park Fair at the Grand Floridian. They just reopened very recently after shutting down for COVID. Then they did a lot of refurbishment and they redid a lot of things. So now it's gonna be a bit different. I know Tiana from Princess and the Frog is gonna be there. So that's gonna be really awesome. They've got new food items, but it is a buffet. So I'm really excited for that. And so that's where we're gonna be going next. So I'll see you at the Grand Floridian. Okay, we have just arrived at the Grand Floridian Resort. It's always kind of crazy walking here because I know this is a place that I will never be able to afford. It is so nice here. It's so crazy. Like, they've got these cars just out here in the front. It's just too nice of a resort. Right on the monorail too. I honestly don't even want to know how much it costs to stay in like a balcony room here. It's got to be absolutely insane. But now we are going to walk in right here. And I think 1900 Park Fair is right on the inside. So let's see how that goes. You got the Grand Floridian rug. You always got the guy out here playing piano. And if I remember correctly, 1900 Park Fair is over here to the left. But first, just take a look at this. Just look at that. Incredible. So I was wrong. I think I have to walk a bit further in here to go find this restaurant. Here we are at 1900 Park Fair. Got Tiana right there. So we just sat down, and I guess there's a wishing ceremony. And you're supposed to write down a wish that you'd like to come true. So we've got prime rib and turkey to start, followed by some mashed potatoes, carrots, salmon, green beans, some white cheddar mac and cheese, roasted garlic sausage. They have impossible sausage, as well as curry roasted chicken, jasmine rice, Tiana's gumbo, and chicken noodle soup. And then over here they have the usual things that they have at a Disney buffet for kids. You've got the chicken nuggets and pizza. Cookies. Toasted coconut cake, chocolate chip cookies, vanilla cupcake, the Grand Floridian strawberry soup, the world famous strawberry soup. And then over here we've got the vanilla cream anglaise, warm chocolate cake, lemon blueberry cheesecake, fudge brownie, and Grand Floridian Fiancier, which is an almond cake with sea salt, caramel, and toasted meringue. Cinderella is right over here. Check that out. I think it's time for the wish ceremony. Gotta get to my seat.
Simple as a feeling, or your heart's greatest desire. Go!
So this is a cold brew martini, not an espresso martini, it's a cold brew martini.
So I've got some mashed potatoes and salmon, as well as white cheddar mac and cheese and prime rib.
We just left 1900 Park Fair at the Grand Floridian. Now we are gonna go head over to Valet to go get our vehicle to head back to our resort. It was fantastic dinner. It was so great being back there after so many years of that place not being open. So it was good to get back there and try all the new foods they have. It really was delicious. That mac and cheese with the prime rib, so, so good. And I know I'm definitely gonna be back in the future. But now it's time to head back and go to bed. Tomorrow's kind of a down day, not really. I'm going to be going to Aquatica, so it's a water park. It's gonna be kind of a rest, but not that much of a rest. But yeah, I'll see you tomorrow at Aquatica.